The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline the table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Nung kami ay maliliit pa, during Holy Week, especially Good Friday, pinalaki kami ng aming lola na bawal maglaro, bawal malikot, bawal maingay, bawal maligo, bawal maglinis. Dapat nakaupo ka lang. Bakit? Sabi ng lola namin, pag nasugatan ka ng Good Friday, di nagagaling. Maraming mga bawal. Pero katakataka, pag Biyernes Santo, may sabong. Di po ba? Ang daming bawal, pero pag Biyernes Santo, may sabong. At tinatanong namin, bakit po pwede magsabong ng Biyernes Santo, pero hindi pwede maglaro? Ang sagot na matatanda, kaya daw nagsasabong ng Biyernes Santo, patay ang Diyos. Hindi alam ni Lord kung sino yung nasa sabungan. Ano po? Pinagtatawa na natin, but those little traditions, wrong way, has inculcated some of the minds that there are times that you can do evil because God is not looking. We have to constantly remind ourselves, my dear friends, my brothers and sisters, there is no right time to do evil and there is no wrong time to do good. Let me repeat that. There is no right time to do evil and there is no wrong time to do good. The gospel speaks of that. Gird your loin. In all the times, gird your loins. You must be ready and you must do what is good. In all the time. In all the time, because you do not know God when God will take you. What is the first reading trying to tell us? A simple logic. A little good things will always produce blessing. And Saint Paul said, can you imagine the sin of one, how it affects the many? If you can imagine that, the sin of one affects the many. So the logic is also the same. The good of one affects the many. If we are ready to do good and we do good, then we become a blessing not only to ourselves, but to the people around us. Minsan hindi natin kagad nararamdaman ang biyaya, kaya hindi tayo nagsusumikap gumawa ng mabuti, kahit man lamang para sa ating sarili, but it's good also to remind ourselves that the little good we do will bless not only us, but the people around us. Keep that in mind. You as a parent, the little things you do, the prayers you said, will not only bless you, but the people around you. Sabi ng aking kapatid, ipagdasal mo naman ang anak ng kanyang kaibigan. Sabi ko, sino? Yung nakapost na namatay? Oo. May sakit kasi yun eh. Sa hindi inaasahang pagkakataon, lumawas lang ang tatay sa Maynila. Nakaligtaan ng mga taong iniwanan niya. Natagpuan siyang wala ng malay nang dalhin sa hospital, dead on arrival. For 20 years mo binabantayan dahil may sakit. A special child. Anong malungkot na kwento? Namatay siya nang wala ka sa iyong piling. Nobody knows. Ang sabi nga, nalingat lang. Binawian na ng buhay. Or the psalm would say, in the twinkling of an eye, things will change. Sa isang kisap mata, napakaraming pwedeng mangyari. Kaya kung ikaw ay magpapabaya, baka mas malaking bagay ang mawawala. Again, my brothers and sisters, there is no wrong time to do good, and there is no right time to do evil. Again, my brothers and sisters, there is no wrong time to do good, and there is no right time to do evil. Think of good things. And if wrong things are done, many have suffered. How much more if we do the right thing always? Kung mayroong nagdurusa, dala ng pagkakamali, isipin nyo ang daming pinagpapala sa paggawa ng mabuti. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We now go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.